प्रणाम गुरु जी।
हाँ प्रणाम. ओके सो एनीबडी एल्स हैज एनी क्वेश्चन? सरवणन, डू यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन? लास्ट टाइम यू आर मिसिंग.
Yes, Guruji. So I just went through the conditioned consciousness and
या
I have been like reflecting on my understanding. Yeah.
ओके
So the thing is, when Brahman is all there, he's the only one. Where is the upadhi coming from for the Brahman as well? Is
So that's
it
what I told you, no? Upadhi is
Brahman?
like you are sleeping. While you're sleeping, you are Saravanan. Dream, you become Saravanan, going to London, Paris, everything. They are all Upadhis. So dream.
Okay. So it's again like it's part of Brahman, which is or
It's
which of
part of
Brahman.
Brahman. Brahman has no parts.
Yeah, so
It's an appearance of Brahman.
there is a reason like why we go through these three phases waking, dream, right, and deep sleep. For Brahman, it's just one, right?
So Brahman has no dream, deep sleep, anything.
Correct. Okay.
Brahman is there's no states for Brahman.
Yes.
Maya appears in Brahman. In the Maya, everything appears as Upadhi and all those things. It's not a dream of Brahman, it's a dream in Brahman.
Dream in Brahman. Okay. Yeah, maybe I will spend some more time reflecting on this. It's little, yeah, tricky.
Okay.
Yeah, I will spend more time. Maybe I will get
Okay.
it.
So anybody else has any question? Rajni? Yes, any questions? Unmute, unmute, unmute first.
Pranams, Guruji.
Abrams.
The question again was on conditioned consciousness. I will also go through this video again and again to get the whole gist of it. But if it is all Brahman only, so it is
Ah.
nothing but a play of Maya only then.
Right, correct, correct.
So it is just a play of Maya, and if I understand this, then I'm out of it. Now, the thing is that through the videos, it is crystal clear who am I. That is okay. But
Okay.
the thing is that it still does not translate into my working in life.
Who is
I
my
the body mind intellect complex takes over,
which is
and
not you?
which is not who, yes. But still I'm driven by it, and then I have to
That
okay.
I am? Who is that I am driven by it?
Huh, it is overridden by BMI. The self is overridden by this thing.
Well, cannot be overridden by BMI.
Okay. So where is the mistake, Guruji?
Mistake is you have to understand who you are and operate from the who am I center, not from the body mind intellect center. So are you married now?
Yes, Guruji.
I am married center. So when you are a mother, you are operating from I am mother center.
Mother center.
So like that, you have to shift your center to I am consciousness.
That practice has to be done.
That's Nididhyasa. Okay. Okay. Anybody else has any question? Yes, Uma. Vijay, any questions?
Guruji,
Prabhuji, I have a question.
Okay, so fine.
Guruji, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಹೇಳೋದೆಲ್ಲ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಅದು ಕೇಳಿದ್ದನ್ನ ಮನನ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದೇನೆ ಇದಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಮತ್ತೆ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಉದ್ಭವ ಆಗೋದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ ಗುರುಜಿ.
ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್.
ಕೇಳೋದು ಮನನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಕೆಲಸ.
ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್.
ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಬೇಡಲೇ ಬೇಡ.
ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್. ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ನಮಿತ್.
ಪ್ರಭುಜಿ, ಹೌ ಡಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಗೋ ಕಮ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅಸ್?
ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಅಸ್?
ಪ್ರಭುಜಿ, ಅಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ this the witness.
See, it is like dream, right? In your dream, okay, you take a dream body, right?
Yeah, we go to a dream and we count, we don't count time only.
Correct. So the ego also comes like a dream. It's not real.
Okay, it claims it's the doer. It claims as it's the doer.
Correct.
Many circumstances form one thing, but it claims I only did everything.
Correct.
I saw this in the doer movie.
Ah, okay, very good.
Is that Avidya, Guruji? That,
yes, that yes. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, so let us continue. I'll project one slide. Can you can see that? Lata, you can stop recording and record one.
Okay, Prabhu. Sure.
No, wait. Continue. We'll do local recording.
Okay.
Okay,
Prabhu.
And right, you have to, the angle you have to reduce the height, so it look like a inclined. Is okay. Okay. Okay, so let us take a prakriya, bondage and liberation. I'm presenting. Make it full screen. Gayatri. The full screen, the lower bar will go. All of you are able to see this bondage and liberation slide. Last week we saw in the triplet prakriya, there are three children. One is a human child, which is made up of biological nature, coming from the human parents. Then a divine child, which is nothing but consciousness. And the society child, which is nothing but mind. Throughout our life, we are struggling with the mind, actually. The entire liberation and bondage is because of the mind. So liberation is to understand that I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am the pure consciousness, Chaitanyam. How do you do that? You have to recognize the divine child in you, which is consciousness, which is Sakshi, awareness. So we see a child as an innocent is divine. It is blissful. It is peaceful. The divine innocence, the divine peace is reflected in the child. That's why everybody enjoys the company of the child. But as you grow up, what will happen to us? Why we get stressed? Why we get worried? From the child to adult, what has happened? That peace is not there. The stress is there. the innocence of the child is gone, replaced by the ego. The mind becomes, mind is full of a stress builds up. When you are born as a child, okay, the child comes the innocence and peace of Shiva, the consciousness, Chaitanyam. The child is in the womb of the mother for 9 months. And in that womb, it is taken care of very well. There's a peace. So it is like almost like this Amazon delivery. Amazon sends a courier to you. So when the courier comes, it is well packaged. There is no damage during transportation. Similarly, the child in the mother's womb is well packaged. Everything is taken care of in the mother's womb. And when the delivery happens, the child is born with the bliss, the peace and silence. The Shiva and Shakti, they are the father and mother. The delivery period is 9 months, just like Amazon delivery takes 2-3 days. The delivery of the child takes 9 months. In that 9 months, child is well packaged in the mother's womb. And the manufacturer, which is Shiva and Shakti, delivers the promise. What is that? The quality is guaranteed. Every child which is born has bliss and peace. Then after some time, as the child grows up, the ego develops. And when the ego develops, so there is a stress building up. So let us look at, take the comparison of the Amazon product delivery. You received the Amazon product. So if you don't like the product, you can return it. But let us say after your use for 6 months and the product is damaged, will the manufacturer take it back? So that's what happens to us. After we grow up, a lot of stress, mental stress develops. The original condition of manufacturing, where is peace and bliss is there of the child, disappears. So now, in this condition, if you go back to the manufacturer, what manufacturer will say? I don't accept it. You go back. So again, you have to take a birth as a child. This is called Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Maranam, Punarapi Janani, Jatreshayanam. So there is a damage during usage of the product. The mind becomes stressful. The peace is gone. So if you die in that stress condition, again you take birth, a fresh birth. Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Maranam. Until you find out how to become peaceful, in just your original peace you gain when you are alive. So this process of gaining back your original peace is called Atmadana. It is called, through self-inquiry, you realize your own true nature. I am the divine child. I am peaceful. I am blissful. In this condition, again you gain your childlike innocence and childlike peace when you are alive. If you go back, you cannot return. There's no return. Otherwise, manufacturer Shiva and Shakti will not accept the defective product. This is called Atmajnana. So from here, a stressed condition, can we go back to our peaceful nature, blissful nature? Can we become blissful like a child, but still functional like an adult? All the knowledge of the adult is there, but internally we are peaceful like a child. And that stage is called Jivan Mukti or enlightenment. So that's why our ancestors said, Makkalagadidre Mukti illa. That means, if you don't have children, you will not get liberation. It is a wrong understanding. It is the meaning of that is Makkalagadidre Mukti illa. You have to become like a child. That is called liberation. Like a child means you have to become innocent and peaceful, but still fully functional in the society. That's Jivan Mukti. So did you see the video? Did you see the picture? Is the communication clear? Any questions are there?
Prabhuji, one question. You told you should become like a child means, do you mean like we should become like a child, or you mean by the qualities of the child?
Qualities of the child, peacefulness of the child.
Okay, the bliss.
Bliss.
Okay. Ananda, the Ananda, Satchit Ananda.
Yes, exactly. Okay. So, anybody else has any question? Or is it clear to everybody?
Pranam Gurudeva.
Pranam Sheetal.
Gurudeva, a child has past life impressions, as you had told in some of the videos. They are in the seed form.
Correct.
Then as we grow up, we see that those seeds are growing up. So seeing the seeds in the light of awareness through Atmajnana, and then understanding that those seeds, that is when we understand that those are what happens to those seeds after we see it in the light of the self.
See, that's actually, you understand it's all dream. In the dream, you under illusion of dream. In the, it's like as if you are waking up in a dream. You realize that it's a dream.
Okay.
A tiger chasing you in the dream, you are afraid. Then suddenly the tiger is nothing but a dream tiger. Your vasanas and impressions are all dream vasanas, dream impressions. In reality, you are the person who is sleeping. Nothing has happened to you. So then what will happen? You will become peaceful like a child.
Yeah. So again, I mean, it will diminish. Basically, it will diminish.
Yeah, it'll diminish. It'll not, circumstances may not change, but you will be very peaceful in any given circumstances.
Yes, Gurudeva, because the projections will not be there
Projections will be there, but it will not be effective.
As you said, it will be there, but you know that it is just, you know, an illusion. And you are not that, and you are the Satchidananda. Yeah.
Right.
Yes, Gurudeva. Thank you, Gurudeva.
Okay. Yeah. So anybody else has a question? So Rajani? Is it clear? Okay. So shall we go to next? Sujay, ore ena prashna idya?
Illa Guruji.
Clear?
No, clear.
Manufacturing defect tagondu vapas hogagilla.
Haudu.
Using defect. Manufacturing defect illa, perfect agide. Okay. I'll project another slide. So you are seeing a slide on reflected consciousness. Let us understand the Chidabhasa or reflected consciousness a bit more in detail. Last week, I gave a prakriya where I give an example of rocket. You are going in a rocket. There is sun behind, and you are not able to see the sun. You are not able to see the light outside because the light requires a reflected surface, reflecting surface or obstruction. Similarly, consciousness is light of the self awareness. Nobody can see consciousness. So to see consciousness, we need a reflecting surface. The reflecting surface is the Maya, the objects in Maya. Without Maya, you cannot see the consciousness. You cannot feel the consciousness. So Maya is the mirror for Brahman. So the pure consciousness, Atman, Brahman, okay, is Sakshi, the witness. The consciousness gets reflected in the mirror called the mind. This reflection is called Chidabhasa. And Chidabhasa reflects on the body. Now the body becomes alive. And the reflected light from Chidabhasa body will go on fall on object. You see an object. If there's reflected light, awareness is not there, you cannot see anything. So original light is Sakshi. The light of the self is Atma Jyoti, awareness. It gets reflected in the mind called Chidabhasa. Chidabhasa reflects in the body, and from body it appears on objects. So you can see everything in the world in the light of Chidabhasa. Chidabhasa is the original light, Sakshi. Chidabhasa is right reflected in the mind from the Brahman, Sakshi. So the mind becomes alive in the presence of Sakshi because of Chidabhasa. So there's a I am thought arises in the mind. That's what happens when you wake up in the morning. The moment you wake up in the morning, I am thought appears. And then that I am thought, I am thought appears as various objects, including body. So then I am thought associated with the body and says, I am body. One who says I am body is called Jiva. The I am, pure I am, is called Ishwara. So the Chidabhasa appears as I am, reflected consciousness. I am appears as various objects of the world. And this objects, one of the objects is called body. And I am identifies with the body called I am body with the thought. So this is called Jiva. When the Jiva recognizes that I am body, you remove, just stay as I am in the Nididhyasa. There's oneness with the Ishwara. When you trace the source of I am, the I is pointing to consciousness, am is pointing to existence. So then you go back to Sat Chit Ananda, which is unmanifest, unborn, which is Sakshi, which is Brahman. So putting in another picture, Sakshi is Brahman. There are no two here. There's no duality here. It's Advaita. And when the Sakshi appears in the mind, in the mere mind, that like it's like a prism. White light falls on the prism and white light breaks into colored lights. Similarly, when the light of Sakshi, Atma Jyoti, falls on Jiva, there's a reflected light. And in that reflected light, the world, a variety of things are seen in the world. In reality, there's Brahman only. So I'll put it in this another way. The pure awareness, Brahman, is I. Okay, it's real I. There's no I thought called I is there. It is pure I. So that falls on, that's the Atma Jyoti, light of the self. It falls on the mind. And the body, through the body, the light goes and you see the world. So the seeing, this process of seeing, this process of light going out is called perception. So there is, in this perception, there are three: object, which is called jnaya; subject called jnatra; and perception is called jnana. So it's a threefold appearance: jnana, jnaya, and jnatra. The object, the subject, and perception. In reality, in Atman or Brahman or Sakshi, these three are not there at all. These three appear more like a dream. So then what is the Nididhyasa? Nididhyasa is you take your attention back to Sakshi. I am the Sakshi. So then what will happen? This experiencer, pseudo, it's not real experiencer. For example, in your dream, you are sleeping in your bed. In your dream, you become Cinderella and go all around the world. You see the world. Cinderella and the world are unreal. Then you realize, I'm not the Cinderella, but I am the sleeping person. I'm Sakshi or the witness. So then the perception, the perceiver and perceived, they both merge. There's no object-subject duality. Then attention of Sakshi goes back to Brahman. So when you understand that world, all these things in the world, body, mind, and intellect, jnana, jnatra, jnaya, all these are mithya or unreal. Then you go back to Brahman or non-dual Brahman, pure awareness where there's no other. So I can give an example of a movie. The light of this light, the screen is Sakshi, the witness. Okay, the projection is the mind. The light which passes through the projector is called Chidabhasa. The bulb is the awareness, Sakshi. On the movie, on the screen, there are a lot of characters appear. Picture keeps changing, but the screen doesn't change. I am the Sakshi, the screen which doesn't change. I am the light of awareness. The picture is being projected by the mind. This is when Mahārāmāyaṇa, this is illustrated through story of Maya Mṛga. A deer appears. It's called Maya Mṛga. It's a golden deer. Sita is attracted by golden deer. She tells Rama to go and get the deer. Rama goes and Sita is kidnapped by Ravana. Similarly, our mind creates a golden deer. The attention goes there. Then we forget the self or Atma Rama. Rama is the innermost self, Atma. So we have heard a story of a king called Narcissus. A king called Narcissus. Narcissus was a king in Greece. He was very, very handsome. And that handsome king falls in love with his image. He has a lake, he has a pond in his house, in a palace. He keeps on looking his pond in the his face in the pond and falls in love with his image. The story goes, he dies of hunger. He doesn't even eat food. He is in love with his image. And in his name, the psychiatrists call a disease called narcissist, one who falls in love with the image. What about us? We also fall in love with our image. We think that I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect, I am a husband, I am wife, I am somebody. So that somebody is an image. We start believing our image. Somebody says you are beautiful, you think you are beautiful. Then one day your hair starts becoming white, then you start feeling hurt because you think you are beautiful. None of our image is view, I. Image we see in a reflected mirror. Okay, what I see is not I. I cannot see myself. I am the original. Right? I am the self. The self is Sakshi. Sakshi cannot be seen. So any image you have to use as a means to get back to yourself. The image is reflected in the mind. The world is a reflection. Your mind is a reflection. Any thought or feeling is a reflection in the mind. So mind is the mirror. Using the mirror, you have to look back at your face. Mirror is there only to see your face. Mirror is not there to fall in love with the mirror image. Right now, we are falling in love with our image. I am a woman. I am mother. I am wife. I am husband. I am engineer. These are all images. Come out. Don't be like narcissist. Recognize yourself as Sakshi. You are the one who is seeing the image in the mirror. So when you sit for meditation, thoughts will come. Please understand these thoughts are nothing but images. They're reflections. Go back to the seer, Atma. I am the seer. So Sri Ramana Maharshi says, ask the question, who am I? And be still, Summaniru. Koham, who am I? And be still. So if you are able to be in your awareness, I am Sakshi. That's called Sahaja Sthiti or natural state. Natural state is not a special state. Oh, I'll sit in meditation, I become Sakshi. No, Atma, no. The natural state has to happen in your waking state, dream state, deep sleep state. You should be very naturally be aware, I am the Atma. I am the Self. That realization is called Jivan Mukti or Sahaja Sthiti. For that, you have to do self-inquiry, who am I? And be still, abide in the Self. I am the Self. And the knowledge you gain is, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am pure consciousness. The self-inquiry involves, self-atmadhana involves three steps. Self-inquiry, who am I? So I am not the image, I am not the reflection, I am not the mirror. I am the one who is seeing it, Sakshi. So be, abide as Sakshi, be as Sakshi. First is self-inquiry, who am I? Then abiding in the self as Sakshi. Then atmadhana. Atmadhana is self-knowledge. What is the self-knowledge? I'm not the body, I'm not the mind, I'm not the intellect, I'm pure consciousness. Nanu, nanembudu, nanalla. Ideha, mana buddhi nanalla. Sachidananda atma, shivanan nane, shivoham. That's called self-knowledge. Self-inquiry, self-abidance, self-knowledge will lead to natural state. This entire process is called nididhyasa. You have to repeat nididhyasa until you are fully established in natural state. That means in the waking state, dream state, deep sleep state, you're still aware, I am the Atman. Just like you are aware that I am the mother or I am the wife, in any circumstance, you have to be aware, I am Atman, I am Brahman, in any circumstance in life. So, did you listen? Any questions?
Prabhuji had messaged in the chat.
You have a question in the chat?
Yeah.
No, no. Telling he is the body, right? See, his question is, Madhvacharya is telling about the duality. No. Okay. I am the body is ignorance, right?
Yeah.
Avidya. Madhvacharya is telling, say, I am the body. You say body is the, I am the servant of God. As a body, I am servant of God.
Okay.
Okay. He is not telling about ignorance. He is telling us how to become free from ignorance.
Okay.
So I'll tell you one story of Hanuman. Okay. Understand. Somebody asked Hanuman, okay, who are you? What is Rama to you? Hanuman said, when I open my eyes, I feel I am a body and this world. So when you say I am the body, I am Jiva, right? That's ignorance. So then Hanuman says, immediately I say I am the servant of Rama. I am God's servant. So Madhvacharya is saying, if you are body conscious, we have to think we are God's servant.
Okay.
Right? If you think I am the body, the ego will develop. Instead of that, if you say I am the God's servant, ego will develop, ego will reduce.
Okay, and one more thing, Prabhuji, I had one question. When somebody asked Buddha, no, who are you? He told, I am the awakened one. How can he tell to a Agnani?
How can he?
Tell to a Agnani.
Okay, I'll tell that. Okay, now Hanuman's story I'll complete, right? Then Hanuman says, when I open my eyes, okay, when I open my eyes, I am feeling I am the body. That time I think I am some servant of God. Madhvacharya said, we always should think we are servants of God. We should not think we are a body. You understand the difference?
Yeah.
Clear or not?
Yeah, I'm clear.
Madhvacharya is not telling you about ignorance. Madhvacharya is telling how to come out of ignorance.
Okay.
Right? That's called Dvaita. Okay. Not Dvaita is not duality. Duality, ignorance, is telling us how to come out of ignorance.
Okay.
Then Hanuman says, if I close my eyes and I meditate, I feel I am related to Rama. Rama is relative. Rama is my friend. Right? This is what Ramanujacharya said. We are all related to God in meditation.
Okay.
Then Hanuman says, when I enter into Samadhi, deep meditation, Nididhyasa and Samadhi, Nirvikalpa Samadhi, then there is no Hanuman, there is only Rama. This only Brahman.
Okay.
So this is what Ramanuja Shankaracharya told. If you enter into Samadhi, you are Brahman.
Okay.
So Madhvacharya, Ramanujacharya, Shankaracharya told different stages of our life.
Okay. Then was Ramanujacharya also telling what he also supporting like Madhvacharya told, you know, we should become the servant of God. So did even Ramanujacharya tell like that?
Correct. They are also telling same thing. When you are meditation and when you are Samadhi, you are Brahman. You are one with God, right?
Yeah.
But when you open your eyes, you become body conscious.
Okay.
So when you become body conscious, okay, we start becoming egoistic. So instead of egoistic, we say, I am servant of God and we have to do karma yoga and bhakti yoga as a devotional service to God.
Okay.
So then if you meditate, you feel connected to meditation. While meditation, you can't do any work, no? You are sitting in meditation. That time you are feeling very close to Rama, very close to God. That's what Ramanujacharya said.
Okay.
Now Shankaracharya, Madhvacharya, Ramanujacharya are telling same thing in different ways. Shankaracharya is telling when you are in Samadhi what will happen. Ramanujacharya tells when you are in meditating what will happen. Madhvacharya tells when your eyes are open, how you have to service.
Okay.
Right? They are not telling about ego. Adnana they are not telling. They are telling about Jnana only.
Okay.
Right? So now Buddha told he is awakened to a person who is asking, right?
Yeah.
Now the person who is asking is not an ordinary person. He is also a very good, very mature seeker.
Okay. Even he is like Swami Vivekananda. He is a truth seeker.
Huh?
Was he also like Swami Vivekananda?
Yeah. He was a truth seeker. So to teach him, Buddha says, I am an awakened one.
Okay.
Yeah.
But how does Buddha know that he is interested in knowing Atma Jnana?
So that's because Buddha is able to understand. Now Buddha is so evolved, he can understand. A teacher can understand where the student is.
Okay.
Right? Okay. Anybody else? Any has question? So everybody is enlightened.
It's clear, Guruji. It's that you have to be conscious and aware every moment to live by.
We are getting trapped in our own images.
Yeah. Yeah, the image is very strong right now.
So Rajani,
Yeah, very beautifully explained, Guruji. Especially the video. Very clear.
Very clear.
Yeah, we have to go through this video again. I'll go through it again.
Okay. Sheetal, any questions?
Gurudeva, no questions, Gurudeva.
Okay. Okay. Uma, any questions?
No, Guruji.
Here?
Yeah.
So then we can close the class here now. No more classes.
Right.
No, Prabhuji, still we are not enlightened. There is so much. Just we have learned till H2 or I. We should learn till A to Z, everything we should learn.
Okay.
We have to internalize, Guruji. We have to internalize what you have teaching.
even that is coming from our ego that
I
don't want you to give up.
Guruji.
Yes, Kate.
ಇವಾಗ ಹೇಗ ಅನ್ಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಮೂರೇದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಿ ನೋಡಿ, ಅದ ಎಷ್ಟು ದಪ್ಪ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಈ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನ ಹಣ್ಣದು ತಗೊಂಡು ತೆಕ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಈಗ ಏನ್ ಅನ್ಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಡಿಯೋಸ್ ನೋಡಿ, ಆತ್ಮದರ್ಶನ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ಬಂದು ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಎಕ್ವೈರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರುವಾಗ ಇನ್ ಗೋಡೆ ತುಂಬಾ ತೆಳ್ಳಗಾಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು 2-3 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಇದೆ. ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಆಗೇ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಬೆಳಕು ಪೂರ್ತಿ ಕಾಣಿಸುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ.
ಓಕೆ
ಗುರುದೇವ.
ಎಸ್ ಪ್ರತಿಪ್. ಎಸ್, ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್?
ಶೀತಲ್ ಹೇರ್ ಗುರುದೇವ. Gurudeva, in one of the last the last videos, that is superimposition videos, a video, there was an adhyasa which is known as anyonya adhyasa. A little bit more clarity I need in that, Gurudeva.
Anyonya adhyasa. Okay. Yeah. See, anyonya adhyasa is a superimposition. You're sitting in a boat. Right? You're sitting in a boat. And you start seeing the trees are moving.
Yes.
But tree is not moving. Boat is moving.
Yes.
But you don't realize boat is moving.
Yes.
Right? The boat movement superimposes in the tree.
Yes.
Right? Similarly, you are sitting in a train. Suddenly you feel your train is moving. Your train is moving. The next train is moving and you feel your train is moving.
Yeah.
So you can superimpose what you are to or what is other on you. Correct?
Yeah.
Anyonya adhyasa is taking place. Mutual superimposition is happening. So what is Atma? Atma is the light. Atma Jyoti, awareness. That awareness of Atma Jyoti falls on the body. Body is jada, inert.
Yes.
But you start thinking that body is alive.
Yes.
So this superimposition of Atma on Anatma is doing. You're doing.
Yeah.
So now, on the other hand, the body is born and body dies. The nature of the body is superimposing the Atma. I am also born, I am also dying. Nature of Atma, you are superimposing the body. Nature of body, you are superimposing the Atma. This is called Anyonya Adhyasa.
Okay, so this is mutual superimposition.
Correct.
So one thing is, one way we are already superimposing on the Swarupa. Then, as you said, on the second level is on the that is, we are associating it again.
Correct.
And then we are mutually mixing it up.
Correct.
This is the third level of adhyasa. Anyonya adhyasa.
I don't say third level. It's only one adhyasa. Bring in third level. It's anyonya adhyasa.
Yeah, because you said there are three types of adhyasas in the condition. First is, as you said, the first one is we confuse it with the body swarupa adhyaya swarupa adhyasa
is finally called adhyasa. Only one adhyasa we are going through, mixing up everything finally. Right, so body you are mixing with the mind, atma you are mixing with the body and mind, body and mind we are mixing with the atma.
Yeah,
that's called anyon adhyasa.
Okay Gurudev,
right, where that anyon adhyasa is cause for our bondage bandhana.
Yes Gurudev, sure. Right? Thank you Gurudev, thank you.
Welcome.
So it is like both anyonya adhyasa is nothing but swarupa and samsarga both together mixed now, Guruji.
Correct. Swarupa and samsarga adhyasa together is called anyonya adhyasa.
Okay, fine.
Third type. It's a both together. The anyonya adhyasa, swarupa adhyasa and samsarga adhyasa is only told to explain so anyonya adhyasa which is taking place.
Okay, both together is called anyonya adhyasa.
Right.
Okay, thank you.
So, are we clear? Anybody else question? We will meditate. Huh? Yes, Pradipa? Yes, Pradipa?
Today's best was not.
Yes, Taila?
Today's best was not.
Uh-huh. Yes, Taila? ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಟೈಪ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಥವಾ ನೀವು ಗಟ್ಟಿಯಾಗಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕು. ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ,
ಗುರುಜಿ. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಶಿ ವಾಸ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಸೇ ಟುಡೇಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್.
ಆ ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ, ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದಿರಾ. ಓಕೆ, ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್. ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ಅಂತರ್ ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ.
Gurudev, can I ask one thing, please, if you don't
know? You can ask any number of things.
Yeah. Actually, when you said in the morning, actually, I was contemplating on this, but I think it's better I ask only. When we say that Maya is an Upadhi. Upadhi.
Upadhi, yes. Upadhi means adjective. Conditioning. Yeah.
Conditioning, which is imposed on Brahman.
Which is not imposed on Brahman, which is superimposed on Brahman. Brahman has no bondage.
Brahman has no bondage, yeah. But Ishvara has got the conditioning already.
Ishvara?
Yeah, he has got this conditioning already.
See, Brahma, it's like you can think, Brahman is the person who is sleeping. So person who is sleeping has no problem, right? He is resting and relaxed.
Yeah.
He gets a dream.
Yes.
Person who is sleeping has a imagination ability. The imagination ability appears as a dream.
Yeah.
In the dream, same person appears.
Yes.
Okay. The Brahman has an imagination ability called Maya. Brahman is sleeping. He never has any problem. Always he is free. Like that's why Narayana is relaxing. Correct?
Yeah.
But in this dream, Narayana takes the form of Vishnu, Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara, all those dream characters.
Yeah.
And it takes the dream characters, all dream characters, including you and me.
Yes.
Correct? So yeah. The one who, when he takes the, becomes the ruler of the dream world in the form of Vishnu, he is called Maheshwara. Vishnu, dream. Only Narayana is out of the dream. Narayana is a sleeping person. He is not in the dream.
Yes.
Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara also in the dream.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Your question is, do they know they are in the dream? They actually more aware, or they are aware of their Brahman nature, Ishvara. They are not trapped by Maya. They use the Maya.
Okay. So can we say that Ishvara, that is the one who is in the dream already, still he has total sattva guna, that's why he is aware of his...
Correct.
Okay, so we are actually going closer to the sattva guna.
Yes. See, okay. In Ishvara, when you say Ishvara, it's actually when you sit in silence, that's a pure I am feeling, existence feeling. I am the body, is jiva. Just go back to pure I am, you are going to Ishwara only.
Yes,
don't start imagining Ishwara as some person. Ishwara is the pure I am feeling with you, in you. I am not associated with the body, just I am.
Yes.
When the I am, just I am is there, that's called Ishwara. When it becomes I am the body, it's called jiva. When you go to pure I, where there is no I am, then it's Parabrahma.
Parabrahma, yeah.
Sakshi.
Yes. Yes.
Sakshi is Parabrahma.
Yes, Gurudeva. Yes.
Right?
So this dream, so we cannot understand that why this dream came to Brahman. We cannot say, ask like this.
You have to ask yourself only.
Sorry?
You have to ask yourself only. You are also Brahman. See, in life, in nature, there is no answer. The question why? There's always question what? For example, tell me why fire is hot. The nature of fire is hot. It's a prakriti. You cannot say why it is like that. Nature of Brahman is Maya. So you cannot say why Maya is there.
Okay. Yeah. So, Gurudeva, so when I sleep, for example, I sleep, okay, is it due to the tiredness or is it due to my nature I am sleeping?
No. When the body, see, the mind, the ego catches hold of the body. Right? And it forgets its own nature. It catches all the body to get happiness.
Yes.
Body is tired. And the ego will leave the body for some time. So that because body is tired. So that is called sleep. Ego will leave its hold on body. It's like you have a horse. You are using the horse to go all over the city. When the horse is tired, you allow the horse to rest. You also take rest. So like that, ego takes rest, allowing the body, body is nothing but horse of ego, to take rest.
Yeah. So this rest is the one which is uniting me with my Swarupa.
Who is me? Who is me?
Yes, the ego is the me.
Ego is not me. Ego, your me, yes, Swarupa, your Swarupa has never changed.
Yes, yes, the Swarupa never changes. Yeah.
See, are you a mother?
Yeah.
Are you a wife?
Yes.
So, when you are a mother or a wife, are you a woman? Are you?
Yes, of course. Yes.
Always you are a woman. Your Swarupa never changes. Whatever you are, your Atma never changes, your Swarupa doesn't change. When you are a mother, you may forget that you are a woman momentarily. Forgetfulness doesn't mean that your Swarupa has changed.
Yes. Yes.
How can you tell me?
I could not hear the last sentence.
Your Swarupa cannot change at all.
Yes, it cannot change at all. Yes.
Is there any meaning in saying I am united with my Swarupa? Is there any meaning in that?
It's meaningless, yes. It is total meaningless, yeah. Yes. I agree.
Okay.
Yes, Gurudev.
Yeah. So let us meditate Antarnididhyasa. I hope there is a everyday daily meditation class goes on. You can download the meditation and practice daily meditation for 1 hour class. Right? So variety of meditation I am teaching, you can go through that. So we'll look quickly the Antarnididhyasa. I'll chant first, repeat. Brahmadnana Valivala. Sakrat. Shravana Matrena ब्रह्मज्ञानम यतो भवे ब्रह्मज्ञान वली माला सर्वेषां मोक्ष सिद्धये श्री शंकराचार्य इज टेलिंग बै लिसनिंग टू द स्तोत्र ब्रह्मज्ञानावली माला यू विल गेट ब्रह्मज्ञान बै जस्ट श्रवण मात्रेना लिसन एंड यू विल बिकम प्यूरिफाइड एंड यू विल अंडरस्टैंड आई एम ब्रह्मन सो फॉर दैट पर्पस ही हैज गिवन ब्रह्मज्ञानावली माला श्लोक वाली माला श्लोक सो नाउ दिस श्लोक वी यूज फॉर मेडिटेशन और निधिध्यास असंगोहम 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 पुनः पुनः I am unattached. Again and again, you have to remember. Sachidananda Rupoham. I am existence, consciousness, bliss. Ahameva. Aham avyayaha. I am limitless. I am boundless. This we have to remember again and again. That's what is Nididhyasa. So let us do Antar Nididhyasa. Close your eyes. Become aware of the world. The world is an object. I am the seer, the sakshi. Nididhyasa involves three steps. First step is called Rupanu with Savikalpa Samadhi. Become aware of the forms, various forms. So understand what I become aware of forms, I am not the form. The form is an object. I am the sakshi. That's called Rupanu with. Then remember the nature of self, Brahmajnanavali Mala Sloka. So that's called Shabdanuvid. Then finally stay as silent witness. That's called Nirvikalpa Samadhi. So first step number one, Rupanuvid Savikalpa Samadhi. Look at all the forms, the world. World has form. World is an object, I am the subject, I am awareness. Become aware of the body. Body has a form, I am seer of the form, I am the sakshi, the witness. Become aware of the breath. Breath changes. The body changes, the breath changes, the mind changes. The witness of the body, breath and mind, the sakshi does not change. I am the unchanging awareness. Now, Shabdanu with Savikalpa Samadhi. I have to remember the words of Brahmajnanavali Mala. Asangoham, asangoham. I am the sakshi. I am the witness. Witness is unattached. thoughts, feelings, emotions, the pain in the body, suffering, joy, everything appear and disappear in consciousness. I am the witness. I am unaffected by the changes in the body and mind. Asangoham, asangoham, I am unattached. Sachidan rupoham, I am of the nature of existence, consciousness, bliss. Aham avyayaha, I am unlimited, infinite, boundless. Now, stay as your awareness, Sakshi, Nirvikalpa Samadhi. Asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityorma amritam gamaya om shanti shanti shantihi purnamadah purnamidah purnat पूर्णमुदुच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति 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 ही लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु नानु नानेंबुदु नानल्ला इदेह मन बुद्धि नानल्ला सचिदानंदात्म शिव नानु नाने शिवोहम 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 I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am pure consciousness, Shiva Swarupi. Atma Darshanam, Brahma Darshanam, Brahma Darshanam, Satya Darshanam. To know the self is to know the God. To know the God is to know the truth. Rub both of your hands, give warmth to the eyes, and gently open your eyes. Any questions? Misha? Any questions, any feedback? Now, next week assignment.
Guruji?
Yes.
Guruji? Nan Subbalakshmi Matata.
Yes, Subbalakshmi.
Body change feeling was more like.
Yeah.
Tumba jaasti anusta
itu. Clearly.
Particular place feeling gataraya.
Barley. So you have to, that feeling is like a reflection, mirror. You have to understand, yeah. I'm seeing the reflection, I am this ear.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So don't be attracted by what's happening in the body.
Okay.
Who is watching it is you have to be aware of.
Okay.
Guruji?
Yes, Yeshu Vaishnavya. Yeshu Vaishnavya. Sujata, Sujaya.
Sujaya. Adu Anjaneya, first level helide, Dehabhimana iruvaga. ಸರ್ವೆಂಟ್ ಹಾಗೆ ಇರಬೇಕು ದಾಸನಂತೆ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ
ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಸರ್ವೆಂಟ್ ನಮ್ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ದೇಹ ಅಂತ ಅಭಿಮಾನ ಇರುವಾಗ ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ನಾನು ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ತಿರುಗಾಡಬಾರದು
ಹೌದು
ನಾನು ದಾಸ
ಹೌದು
ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮಧ್ವಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಟ್ಟದ್ದು ದಾಸ ಪುರಂದರ ದಾಸ ದಾಸ ಕನಕ ದಾಸ ದಾಸ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ
ಅದು ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್
ಲೆವೆಲ್ ನೀವು ಧ್ಯಾನ ಕುತ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರಿ ಧ್ಯಾನ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಉಪಾಸನೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ ಉಪಾಸನೆ ಧ್ಯಾನ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಉಪಾಸನೆ ಭಗವಂತನ ರೂಪ ಆಕಾರ ನೆನಪು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೇವೆ ಆ ರೂಪ ಆಕಾರ ನೆನಪು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುವಾಗ ಅವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ನನ್ಗೆ ಓ ಭಗವಂತನ ಹತ್ರ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ ನನ್ನ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ ಅದು ವಿಶಿಷ್ಟ ಅದ್ವೈತ ರಾಮಾನುಜಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು ಕಡೆಗೆ ಧ್ಯಾನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸದಲ್ಲಿ ನಿರ್ವಿಕಲ್ಪ ಸಮಾಧಿ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ ಆವಾಗ ನಾನು ಬೇರೆ ಪರಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಬೇರೆ ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಜೀವ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಏಕತ್ವ ಅದು ರಾಮನ್ ಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು
ಅದು ಕೊನೆದು ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ
ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ನೀವೀಗ ನೋಡಿ ಮನಸ್ಸಿನ ಧ್ಯಾನ ಮಾಡಿ ಶ್ರೀರಾಮ ಶ್ರೀರಾಮ ಶ್ರೀರಾಮ್ ಅಂತ ಅವಾಗ ರಾಮನ ಗುಣಗಳು ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಆಗ್ತವೆ ಭಗವಂತನ ಗುಣಗಳು ನೆನಪು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಭಗವಂತನ ಗುಣಗಳು ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಆಗ್ತವೆ ರೈಟ್ Okay, so every week there is a, every day there is a meditation class, 1 hour class. Okay, 4:30 to 5:30. I'm sure maybe some of you people cannot join because of your office or some reason, but it is already there, recorded, it's available. You can go to YouTube. The YouTube channel is different. YouTube channel is called Light of Self Meditation Channel. You can subscribe to that and you can download. You can use it. And every day I am telling meditation in various ways. It's not same meditation every day. Different things I am bringing. Right? So if you listen to my meditation 365 days is different meditation will be there. Atmadhana, same Atmadhana told in many ways. So practice meditation. Then 3 videos. Listen to that. Okay? Anything else? Any other question?
Guruji, Swapna here.
Hi, hello, Swapna.
ಗುರುಜಿ, ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ, ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಪೀಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅನದರ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಆನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅನದರ್ 2-3 hours ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು ದ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್. ಹಾಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ಅವಾಗ ಕುತ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಾ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಅವಾಗ ತಿರ್ಗಾ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ಬೇಕಾ?
ಹೌದು, ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ, ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಫುಲ್ ಡೇ. ಈಗ ನೋಡಿ, ನೀವು ಈ ಸ್ಮೋಕಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ನೋಡಿದಿರಾ, ಚಟ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ, ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರ ಅವರು?
ಅವಾಗವಾಗ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ, ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ಲಿ
ಅರ್ಧ ಗಂಟೆ ಅಷ್ಟರಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಸ್ಮೋಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೊರಗೋಗ್ತಾರೆ.
ಓಕೆ,
ಅವರಿಗೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಚಟ ಇರ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಇರ್ಬೇಕು?
ಬಟ್ ಕೆಲ್ಸಗಳಿರುತ್ತಲ್ವಾ ಗುರುಜಿ, ಹೌ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಆನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಸಿಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್? ಅದು
ಅಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ, ಸಿಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಡ್ರಿ, ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಡ್ರಿ, ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಡ್ರಿ, ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಒಂದ್ ನಿಮಿಷ ಕಣ್ಣು ಮುಚ್ಚಿ ಒಂದ್ ನಿಮಿಷ ನಿಧಿ ದ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡಿ, 1 minute.
ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ 3 times a day ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್.
ರೈಟ್. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ 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 ಕಾಫಿ ಕಾಫಿ ಟೀ ಕುಡಿಯ ಚಟ ಇದೆಯಾ?
ಒನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಡೇ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಗುರುಜಿ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಚಟ, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಹಾಗೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ.
ಆ ಚಟ ಇರ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ ಕೆಲವರಿಗೆಲ್ಲ, ಒಂದು ಅರ್ಧ ಗಂಟೆ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಕಾಫಿ ಕುಡಿಬೇಕು, ಟೀ ಕುಡಿಬೇಕು, ಹಾಗೆ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಈ ಧ್ಯಾನ ನಿಧಿ ಧ್ಯಾಸ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಚಟ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು.
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ,
ಚಟ ಬಿಡಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ಕೆಟ್ಟ ಚಟ ಬಿಡ್ಬೇಕು ಬಿಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಚಟ ಬಿಡಿಸ್ಬೇಕು.
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ,
ರೈಟ್.
ಸೋ ಫ್ಯೂ ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆದ್ರೂ ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ.
ಫ್ಯೂ ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಯಾಕೆ, 1 minute ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಅರ್ಧ ನಿಮಿಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ.
ಓಕೆ, ಅಷ್ಟು ಬೇಗ ಸಿಕ್ಕಲ್ಲ ಗುರುಜಿ, ಅದು ಕಷ್ಟ
ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಆಗ್ತದೆ.
ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಂಟ್ ನಿದ್ದೆ.
ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಂಟ್ ನಿದ್ದೆ ಸರ್, ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್
ಸಿಂಪಲ್ 1 minute ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬ್ರೆತ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಗುರುಜಿ. ಬ್ರೆತ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ವರ್ಕ್, ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಫೀಲ್, ಮೈ ಪರ್ಸನಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೀರಿಯನ್ಸ್.
ಮಾಡಿ ಅಥವಾ ಕಣ್ಣು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗಿ ಅಮ್ಮ ಅಂತ ಮಾಡಿ, ಇಲ್ಲ ಗಂಡನ ಮುಖ ನೋಡ್ತಾ, ಗಂಡ ಹಸ್ಬೆಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಿರರ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೀ ಮೈ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ, ಗಂಡನಿಗೂ ಖುಷಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನಿಮಗೂ ಖುಷಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, 2 in 1. ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಇಲ್ಲ ಗಂಡ ಗಂಡ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಿರುವಾಗ ಬಹಳ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಕೇಳಿ, ಅವರಿಗೂ ಖುಷಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇನ್ ಲೈಫ್, ಮದುವೆ 20 ವರ್ಷ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇವಾಗ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಂತ, ಬಟ್ ನೀವು ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ಲ.
ಗುರುಜಿ, ಸೆಪರೇಟ್ ಚಾನೆಲ್ ಯಾವ್ದು ಗುರುಜಿ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ?
ಅದು ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಾನು ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ, ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸದ್ಗುರು ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಪೋಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಆ ಚಾನೆಲ್ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಮಾಡಿ.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಪ್ರಭುಜಿ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್, ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ ಪ್ರಭುಜಿ? ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಕನ್ನಡ.
ನೋ ನೋ, ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಸಮ್ 1 or 2 hours ಶಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪೀಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್.
ಯೆಸ್ ಯೆಸ್,
ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್.
ಯಾ,
so I give the example of people who are smokers.
Okay,
so every 2 hour, every 1 hour they will go out for smoking.
Yeah,
will take oxygen, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so they need oxygen every 1 hour.
Yes,
it's called addiction.
Okay,
so addiction to meditation is not a problem. I said anytime you get just to take a meditation break.
Yeah,
okay, there are various simple techniques for that.
Yes,
close your eyes and observe your breath. 1 minute. Okay, close your eyes and ask, who am I? Or look at your husband's face very carefully when he's talking. Okay, he is very happy that you are watching him. Okay? Otherwise you'll never look face to face. No, you just watch him. And remember, darpana prakriya, husband mirror, I am watching myself, you remember yourself. So husband also will be happy, your meditation also will be done with your voice open. So make meditation as a habit. Just don't say meditation is 1 hour or half an hour. You have to make it every minute.
Yes, coach.
Right? Or you do some service. And whatever you call as translation, transcription, book writing. In this service, the mind will be always engaged in meditation. Correct?
Yeah.
For me, 24 hours is meditation, whether I close my eyes or open my eyes. So the moment I close my eyes and sit for meditation, ask, Prabhuji, what should I do? Then I'll again meditate and tell someone something. Teaching is meditation for me. Listening is meditation. So meditation is just, don't make meditation as just simple thing. Thinking of God anyway is meditation.
Yes.
whatever work we do, Bhagavad Arpana is meditation.
Yes. Karma Yoga. Right? Your whole life you have to convert into meditation. Meditation is not a part-time activity. Who asked the question? Swapna, right?
Swapna, Guruji. Yes, Guruji.
Swapna, meditation is not a part-time activity.
Okay, Guruji.
You are a part-time mother?
No, Guruji, full-time.
You are a part-time mother, wife?
No, Guruji, full-time.
Okay, like that you have to be full-time meditator. Doesn't mean that you have to close your eyes all the time.
Okay. I'll practice, Guruji.
Okay.
But it's very peaceful. Meditation is really very peaceful.
What is that?
The meditation is really very peaceful.
Very good, very good. What did you say?
Thank you, Guruji.
Stop. Yeah, Lata, you can stop recording.